Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, welcome. My name is Nikki and I make videos about journaling, studying, and vlogs. In today's video, I thought I would share some tips and tricks on how to improve your journaling. I always get a lot of questions or concerns from people who want to improve their journaling and have little to no clue where to begin. So that's why I'm making this video, to hopefully help some of you guys out. Now, before I get into the tips, I wanted to say that journaling is a form of art, and with really any form of art, there is really no right or wrong. And art is there to express oneself, and thus every art style is unique in its own way. So the tips I'm going to share today are based off of my experience, and these are not something you should hold onto and use as a manual on how to improve your journal, but rather use them as an inspiration if you're interested in the journal style that I have. Now, there are a lot of different journaling styles and different types, and that is exactly what makes journaling so much fun. Imagine we would all have the same journaling style. That would be kind of boring, am I right? So with that being said, if you like my journal style, just keep on watching. So if I could describe my journal style, I would describe it as a organized mess. And what I mean by that is that all my journal spreads, or like most of them, have like a kind of similar layout. Of course, I switch things up sometimes and try different things, but generally speaking, there's a certain way that I find my bullet journal the most useful. For example, I like to use around 3 pictures in most of my spreads. Sometimes I would use 4, depending on how big I print the pictures. Usually my pictures are quite big. I know there are some people who would like their pictures to be small, or they don't even use pictures at all, so that depends on every person. Before analyzing my journal style any further, because I think that could be a whole different video by itself, I'm just gonna share the tips that I have with you. So the first tip that I have is that you should use different layers. With what I mean by that is that you should like layer different kinds of paper or really anything that you just have. So this kind of gives your journal spread a little bit more dimension, and so you incorporate different dimensions onto your spread so it won't look monotonous, because that's what makes it kind of like boring, I would say. But again, this is all different for every person, but in my opinion and for my journal style, I like to layer a lot of paper, washi tape, or whatever I just have. And it also gives a kind of like a scrapbooky feeling, which I'm really into. So yeah, that's what I do. You can use like really any paper. I usually rip like paperbacks, or I just use regular paper, and you can use old books, old notebooks, anything that you have that might want to look good onto your journal. Another thing that you can do with layering is that you can like emphasize the stuff that you put on top. For example, if you want to put a picture on top of your layers, that kind of like emphasizes it and like it stands out more. So whenever you want to make something stand out more, what I would suggest is that you put like a lot of different layers underneath. So along with the previous tip that I just mentioned, my next tip is to like outline your pictures or stickers, or really just anything that you want to emphasize. I talked about like emphasizing things in your bullet journal with different layers, and you can do the same with like outlining. And why do I think is emphasizing so important, or why do I think it makes your journal unique? Because if you look at your journal by yourself, for example, in my style, in my case, I like my journal very like kind of messy in a way that when you look at it at first, you're like, whoa, this is a lot. By emphasizing different areas of your journal, it like kind of gives like a nice transition onto your whole journal, and it makes it nice to look at, in my opinion. With layering and outlining, you can achieve that. You can also use like layering and outlining together to make it even stand out more. There are a lot of different ways of outlining. You can use continuous lines, you can use one line, you can use two lines, you can use dashed lines, you can use dots. What I sometimes like to do is not outlining like the outer part of the picture, but outlining like in the middle, if that makes sense. So it kind of looks like a frame. In my opinion, it also gives it a kind of like Tumblr vibe, which sometimes fits into the theme, or like a scrapbooky vibe, if that makes sense. Yeah, these are just some things that you can do. So the next tip might not be for everyone, because I know there's a lot of people who don't like to color coordinate their themes because they're really into like rainbow themes. There are a lot of people who are very, very good at it, but I would recommend, especially if you're a beginner, you should color coordinate your spreads, because it helps you a lot to like kind of give you an idea of how you like your spreads and how you like to mix and match your colors. What I would suggest is that you would start with like one or two main colors, and then you would also use achromatic colors. And achromatic colors are gray, white, and black. These are not real colors. If you guys took any art class, you might already know this. They basically fit with every color, and that's why I would suggest you can use them anytime, so your spread has like more dimensions to it, so there's not only one color or only two colors, if that makes sense. So what I would like to use is that I would like use white paper for layering, and my font is always black, and I sometimes use like gray stickers or gray washi tape. So for the colors, as I mentioned, I would suggest one or two colors. The reason why I'm only suggesting one or two colors is because there are different shades of every color. For example, I probably have like 10 pink brush pens, and I'm not gonna use all different kinds of pink in one of my spreads if I make a pink spread. So try to incorporate like different shades as well, but like not too many, if that makes sense. I don't know if this tip was even helpful at all. Yeah, just kind of like start very basic and then work your way up to like more colors, and then you will see what color combinations you like. For my last journal with me video, I did like a May spread, and as you can see, like the color theme was green and pink. I used achromatic colors, but I know especially if you like use like stickers, there's different like details and different colors. So my May spread, you can also see some kind of brown, some kind of gold, some of the sticker parts were maybe purple or yellow, but these are just very minimal and these don't change the main theme at all. I hope you guys get what I mean, because it's kind of hard to explain. And then my next tip, and I have to say I was struggling so much with this, especially in the beginning. I would fill out every space that I have had in my journal, and then it would look too overwhelming sometimes. Of course, if that's your style, go for it. So for people who are struggling with this too, because they think if they don't fill out every empty space, it would look too empty, I would suggest you would use the space of your journal spread wisely. There are some different main points in your journal. For example, my main points are usually like the beginning where I have the header, and then I usually have like a picture, and then there's like one or two other main points, the parts where I put like my layers and my stationery items onto it, where I don't put like my to-dos on it. Those parts, I would distribute them well onto your journal. So don't make them too close to each other. Don't put like everything onto one place and then leave the rest empty. If everything is like distributed well, I think this gives like a very like nice feeling of your journal. The important part is to have like a good like layout, so everything like matches nicely. But again, there's also some people who like to put everything in the middle and then write around it. This is also very nice if you would like to do that. You don't have to, again, you don't have to follow all of these tips. This is very, very important, is to improve your handwriting or your calligraphy. I don't want to offend anyone with this. Personally, I wasn't born with like a nice handwriting. I know there are some people who are just very good at handwriting. I wasn't, so I had to practice a lot. The same with calligraphy. I think the two most important parts, in my opinion, again, if you're journaling, is the placement of your pictures and your font. So I think if you have like a good placement of your stationery or your pictures or whatever, and you have a bad font that is like kind of messy, not really consistent, it will kind of look weird, in my opinion. If that's the style you're going for, go for it. If you have like a not so good placement but a very, very nice handwriting and a very nice font, I think it's okay. I do a lot of calligraphy, so I had to improve my calligraphy and handwriting a lot, so I had to practice a lot, and there are a lot of videos on YouTube you can watch about how to improve your handwriting. I did that too, and that's how I basically improved my handwriting. You can see now that my handwriting it's more sharp. I think this suits my journaling style a lot more. My handwriting is not perfect, I know that, but I think it got a lot better. Same goes for calligraphy. When I first started out with calligraphy, I was so frustrated, especially because I kept seeing like those people on Instagram who had like perfect calligraphy, and I was like, why can I do this? I know, especially if you're a beginner, you will get frustrated a lot and you will feel like, oh, you can never do it. But trust me, I was there too. I practiced calligraphy for around a year, I think. Eventually, you will get there. And if you want to learn more about how to improve your calligraphy, I actually made a video about that. And I also made like a PDF worksheet for calligraphy practice. So if you want to download that, just click on the video and everything will be in the description box. And then the sixth tip that I have is to add little doodles. I personally think doodles look very cute, especially for beginners. When I first started out, I didn't have a lot of stationery to begin with. Especially I feel like stickers are quite hard to get. They're either expensive or they don't really look nice unless you order them from AliExpress, because I think AliExpress is the best place to shop stickers. But anyway, there are a lot of people who can order from AliExpress for different kinds of reasons. So I would suggest you will just start with doodling. Now, listen, don't be afraid. I am not an artist either, and I'm really, really, really bad at drawing. Fun fact, I didn't even take art in high school. There are some doodles that don't require any artistic knowledge or any kind of experience. You can just search up on Pinterest doodles and then you'll find a bunch of nice and easy doodles, or you can just watch YouTube tutorials. When I first started out, there was not that much, so I had to like kind of like teach it myself. So I think stars, galaxies, flowers, flower petals, hearts, dots, or any kind of different geometric forms are very, very easy to like doodle. And trust me, if I can do it, you can do it too. Don't worry about that. And why is the sun coming out? Okay, I'm sorry for a little change of lightning, but the sun is coming out. For my seventh tip, now I don't know if anyone does this, but when I first started journaling, I wouldn't make a weekly spread at once, but rather like distribute it throughout the week. On Mondays, I would just write my header, and then Monday, and then I would put my to-dos. And on Tuesday, I would just write Tuesday and put my to-dos. And that's what I would do every day. And sometimes if there was like space left, I would put like a picture or washi tape or something. I would suggest just making your weekly spread at once, because first it is more practical, because you have your layout already in your head and you can just put it in your journal, and rather than have to like worry every single day on what you're gonna put into your journal. And also you can make use of the previous tips that I mentioned, like layering and using your space in your journal wisely, so you know where to put down your to-dos every single day you open your journal. That way you can just write your to-dos straight away. Sometimes it kind of gets annoying, especially if you're a student and you're like stressed throughout the week. You don't want to worry about journaling as well. I feel like I was the only person who did this, but yeah, I thought I would just include it anyway. My last tip, and this is like probably one of the most important tips that I have, is to use a good pen. And because your pen is the most important item that you're gonna use for journaling, because you can have the best stationery and the prettiest washi tape and prettiest sticker, but if you have a bad pen, it would just not look good, right? It doesn't have to be like the priciest or the fanciest pen. Now, I would suggest gel pens, and I think most of the people use gel pens, and I think like really any gel pen would do. You have to consider the thickness of your ink. I personally like thinner gel pens for my bullet journaling. Usually I use around like 0.4 or 0.38, or sometimes I would just use 0.3. My favorite gel pen is the Pentel Energel Needle Tip, but really you can use any. I know there are a lot of different gel pens on AliExpress which are very cheap. They are also very good. So that was it for my video on tips on how to improve your journaling. I hope you enjoyed it and that I could give you some inspiration. I hope you guys are doing well during this crazy time, and if you're new to the journal community, welcome, and I hope you will find a lot of joy and inspiration in journaling. And everyone, don't forget to always incorporate your own journaling style. Again, those tips that I just mentioned are only my own personal perception of my own experience, and they might differ from what you like. Again, you should put your own thoughts and likes into your journal so you can express your own and true art style, and thus you can express your own personality. So please don't forget to stay true to yourself and to your own style. And with that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I see you in my next video. Bye! See you soon!